We hit it.
I don't know. Ivor says he's looking good.
Well, have you talked to Nelson?
I don't need to. I know how he feels.
He's in love with you.
All settled in?
Yes, thank you.
Is it just me, or is that a fine specimen of manhood?
The new doctor.
He can be my Valentine anytime he likes.
I thought Marge could pack it away.
I didn't have breakfast.
Shame old. No food in the house.
Well, you tell that father of yours to stock up. You're a growing lad. You need to be fed properly.
Hey, Dad.
Dad? Dad?
If I'd known we'd be keeping you from feeding your family, I'd have planned a morning tea.
Play the same thing over and over?
Why?
There is such a thing as being over-prepared.
You're even making me nervous.
Look, the rest of the guys have already put their tracks down and it's just me tomorrow and I want to get it right.
I'd love to go to a recording studio.
It's not as cool as it sounds.
I'd still love it. I've never been to one.
School and what would Donna say?
I could come.
Be here at the 41,
then. Oh, I've got a study day. Only I've got no studies to do. Swatting up to date, that's me.
Might get a bit hoo-ha.
What, listen to you?
It'll be the same stuff over and over, just like now.
I want to come. I'll get to hang out with you, don't I?
Take a book.
It'll be cool.
Right then, I'm coming.
Okay.
Well, you're going to knock me over with a feather. Let him have it, too.
Well, hang on, I remember you saying that Craig Valentine was a... What was it? A fine specimen of manhood.
Well, I was wrong. He's a monster. I mean, the things Jake's told me.
Well, he's very dedicated to his work.
I don't understand that. He's a doctor. He can afford to look after his kids. I was a solo mum on next to nothing. I managed.
Judy, sorry, but this is kind of urgent.
Oh, right. See you tomorrow.
Yes, see ya.
GC, no one knows where she's gone. She's left the flat, packed her bags and moved out.
I know.
Well, I need to find her.
Well, sorry, I can't help.
Well, she must have told you where she's gone. Judy, please, I need to talk to her.
Well, you've left that a bit late, haven't you?
Just give me a number, something, please.
I can't.
Why?
Because she's asked me not to. Nelson, she's terribly hurt. You know that. She just wants some peace and quiet to sort herself out. I'm sorry.
What?
That woman I told you about?
Yeah.
That's her.
She's too old for you. I hope you turn her down. Have a good day.
Yeah, you too. Morning.
Morning.
Got a long bite to take away, please.
Sure.
Look, we got off on the wrong foot last night. I hope there's no hard feelings.
That's a bit much to ask.
It's no big deal, surely.
Well, you might think that. Frankly, I don't know how you can live with yourself.
Here's Chelsea. Ignore her. If we keep our heads down, she'll keep picking on us. Uh-oh. But pretend we're talking about something else.
Hi.
Weird.
Yeah.
What? What?
Look, up at the counter.
Oh, I'm sorry.
She fancies my brother. That's why she's being nice.
Two-faced cow. After everything she's done to us.
No, this is good. This could be really good.
Why?
Because if we're brainy about this, we could get her back. For everything.
I thought you said to ignore her.
It's a bit rude, just leaving without even saying goodbye.
Well, she was pretty unhappy.
Yes. Did she leave money for her share of the phone and power bills?
Oh, let's see now. Who earns the most in this flat? Oh, that would be the doctor, wouldn't it?
I've got a student loan to pay back.
Hey, I'd like to contribute. I've been heaps.
Obvious, she can't stop gawking at him.
Pathetic.
I saw that.
He so wouldn't be interested. Hello, she's up to something. Chelsea wants you to come over.
Really? Tell her we're happy where we are, thanks. Tell her I know she fancies my brother, and if she wants any info on him, she should come and ask herself. She's gonna hate you. No, she's her best friend now. Watch. See?
Hiya. What are you up to today?
Meeting Shannon?
Oh, good. You can give me a hand.
Pleasure.
And I want you to be a bit nicer to Jake, now that I know what I know.
Have you ever thought his father doesn't like him because he's not a very nice person?
Well, his father?
No, Barb, Jake. Jake's not a very nice person.
Rubbish. All the boy needs is some love and attention and support.
He's a little snot. Don't waste your time.
You know what Craig said to me this morning?
He wished he'd fostered him out when he had the chance?
No. The way he's treating him is no big deal.
Yep, I'm with Craig.
Delphi, here is a boy who doesn't get a home-cooked meal unless he cooks it himself.
And that's what he said.
Yeah, and his sister's a little... poor kid. I just feel so sorry for him.
You're deluded, Barb.
Yeah, so, Jessie packed up all her stuff and she's moving overseas. That's not the best news.
Yeah, no, it sucks.
Hi.
Hi.
How's it going?
Great. Got nearly a grand in outstanding staff tabs here. The nurses always pay them back, but the office staff never do.
How are you really?
Don't.
Look, I'm sorry. I miss you, okay? And I just wanted to say hello.
Thomas putting down a couple of tracks today. I'm going to go watch.
Cool.
Yeah.
Well, it must be good to have Tommy back to help out.
Yeah. We're getting along okay. Really well. Ready to go?
Yeah.
See ya. Have a good day.
You too.